Today, I'm gonna talk about the Python package pathlib. Let's say if you wanna return a path, and the path may be different on Windows, Linux, or Mac. As we all know, Windows and Mac are different when displaying slashes in path. That's why we need to return a path that can be displayed across operating systems. It's just like this function, getPath. Here you can see the path text variable is a text string. Here I use the F string notation to present the path text. This part is our current working directory, which is where this Python file is in. Since it's a function, you can call it out later and sub in your self-defined attributes. Here I use a variable called considerability with pathlib, so I can keep the backward slash in Mac convention. You see the backward slash? It's followed by the path name. In this case, I refer to the language.csv. This one, lang.csv, is in G drive, which is my SD card. And then the folder pybkp, Python bookkeeping, and the file lang.csv. So the type is .csv, the path name is lang, then .extension, which is a csv. This ext variable enables you to specify the file extension. That's in this case, down here, this variable lang path is calling the getPath function that has three parameters. The first one is cwd, as we mentioned before. The get current directory. It's stored in a variable cwd. The second parameter is path name. As we mentioned before, it's the lang.csv. Then for the extension, we have csv down here. When we run it, let's say we pick another file instead of lang, back to this folder where the run exppython is located. This directory is gdrive pybkp. Let's pick fill, this one. So we change this to fill, F-I-E-L-D. It's also a CSV, save the Python file. Now you can see, sd.write, my current working directory is gdrive pybkp. Then we go to this code st.write. This is your lang and then the path. Here I didn't change the word lang. Let me change it to fill, save it. Then this will be changed to fill. This is the fill and then the path. Gdrive pybkp fill.csv. Down here, let's say change this language to fill. It shouldn't be called lang path, it should be fill path instead. So change this to fill, save it, then this will be the fill table. Indeed, it's the CSV file here. This one, reference, fill name, Japanese, Chinese, whatever. There we go. Change it back to language, this one as well, save it, and it will be back to language. Alright, that's what the pathlib does to the path. Let me recap. Pathlib can modify the file path to be able to work with Mac, PC, and Linux that returns the correct path in the user's operating system. Here you see me using the backward slash inside path text, which is a Mac convention. But my app is running on Windows, and you see my file path here has forward slash. That's it for today. Ciao!